and shavasana. Let's start there, like we normally do. Lie down, relax the whole of the body, from the crown of the head down to the tips of your toes. And from the tips of your toes all the way up to the crown of your head. Close the eyes, observe the breath as it flows in and out through the nose. Good. Just a few breaths to bring the mind and body and breath into the practice. And then we'll bring a little bit of energy into the body by taking a deep breath in through the nose. And a big breath out through the mouth. Deep breath in through the nose. Big breath out through the mouth. Deep breath in. And a big breath out. On the next inhale, sweep the arms up behind you, bring the feet together, long stretch. And then as you breathe out, bring the arms up and over, knees into the chest, give yourself a hug, a little rock from side to side. And then come to centre. So leaving the hands on top of the knees, we're going to start with big knee circles, taking the knees out to the side, circling them down to the front of the mat, bring the knees together, and then back up towards your chin. So you have to make sure that you engage your core a little bit so that your lower back doesn't come up too much. And see if you can connect the movement and the breath. So inhaling as the knees come up towards you, and then exhaling as you're circling them out and down. Just big circles, nice and slow with the breath. Good. And then the next time the knees are up towards your chin, reverse that flow, go the other way. Knees to the bottom, then circling them out, and then bring them back together. Keeping that connection to the breath, if you can. Good. And then on the next time the knees are up towards the chest, hold it there. Take an inhale, just squeeze the knees into the chest, and exhale both feet to the floor with the knees bent. Reverse pigeon, inhale your right ankle across your left knee. And exhale that right knee away from you. Inhale, lift your left leg up towards you. Interlace the hands behind your left hamstring. Or place the hands on the opposite leg. And just bring it towards you that way. Slowly breathing into that stretch. On the exhale, gently bringing that left leg a little bit closer towards you. Good, take an inhale and an exhale. Place both feet back to the floor with the knees bent. Inhale your left ankle across your right knee and then exhale that left knee away from you. Inhale, lift that right leg up towards you and hold. You can interlace behind the right hamstring or just place it on the opposite leg. And slowly breathing into that stretch. Good, take an inhale and exhale, release both feet back to the floor with the knees bent. Coming into a quad stretch, grab hold of your left foot with your right hand, draw it underneath the opposite leg. Drop that knee to the floor, extend that right leg along the floor. Sweep the left arm up and over. Stretching from your left fingertips down to your left knee. Inhale, release, place both feet back to the floor with the knees bent. Take an exhale, and then the opposite way round. Inhale, take your right foot through, grab hold of left hand, drop that right knee to the floor. Extend that left leg along the floor, right arm up and over. Good. Nice little stretch from your right fingertips down to your right knee. Good, take an inhale, then on the exhale, release, bend both knees, both feet back to the floor. Take an exhale, then on the next inhale, knees into the chest, little squeeze in. Take your hands behind the knees and then a little rock up to seated. Come to cross leg. If you need to use a block, just pop that on the knees, you drop the hands to the knees, sit up nice and tall. Chin parallel to the floor, just going to adjust the seat, close the eyes. We're just going to take a moment to set our intention. That's a bit better. And tune in with our breath. So our intention for today, so feel connected. Feel connected to the things around me, to the world around me, to the people around me. I feel connected and I feel grounded. And let that, just repeat that a couple of times for yourself. And then let that go. Taking our attention to our breath. So that three-part breath where we breathe into our belly, into our rib cage, into our collarbones. Having that little moment before you then start the exhale, drawing that whole breath out from your belly, your collarbones, sorry, ribcage, collarbones. So actively breathing, mindfully breathing. Staying connected to the breath throughout your practice, if you can. Just always drawing your mind back to that breathing in and that breathing out. Good. On the next inhale, open the eyes. Leaving the hands on the knees, we're just going to do big circles. So taking the body over to the left, circling forward, over to the right, and then leaning into the hands to the back. So just big, big circles if you can. Keeping the hips heavy, keeping the knees dropping down. Good. Another couple this way around. And the next time you're forward, reverse that flow, go the other way. So holding onto your knees so that when you go back, you can lean into that a little bit. Just really exaggerating that movement. Good. And then coming to centre. Sitting up tall, take an inhale. Exhale, twist round to the left fingertips behind, right hand behind your left knee. Coming all the way around, take your gaze over your left shoulder. Relax the knees. Breathing into that twist. And as you're breathing out, moving into that twist a little bit further. And you create that space. Inhale, lift and lengthen, and exhale, walk the hands out in front, let the upper body drop down, chest down towards the floor, relax the upper body, release the head. Next inhale, walk the hands back towards you, lift up, sit, nice and tall, switch the legs around, take the other shin in front, take an inhale and then exhale, twist round to the right, right fingertips behind, left hand behind your right knee, taking that gaze all the way around your, over your right shoulder, relax the legs, the knees, sit up tall. to centre. Inhale, lift, and then exhale, walk the hands back out in front. Upper body relaxes down towards the floor. Relax the head. Good. On the next inhale, lift your gaze, walk the hands back towards you. Take the hands underneath the knees, lift them up, and then lie down onto your back and grab hold of your strap. Placing the strap around the ball of your right foot, extend that right leg up to the sky, lengthen that left leg along the floor. If it feels really uncomfortable, you can keep the left knee bent and place the foot on the floor. And then slowly let the hands drop down, slide them along the strap until the elbows drop down to the floor. Keep the elbows tucked into the rib cage, and it's just a gentle hold, not pulling. Okay, slowly, slowly extend that right leg. So you only want to go to where you can keep the leg straight, don't let the knee bend. So it might be that your leg is quite a lot forward, which is fine. And then slowly breathing into the back of that leg. Let the hips be heavy. And then maybe after a couple of breaths, bring that leg a little bit closer towards you. And then maybe a little bit closer again, only if it feels comfortable. Good. Taking the straps onto your right hand, take an inhale. And then exhale, let that leg drop out to the right side, all the way down, as far as the leg will let you go. Be mindful of keeping that right leg up towards the top right corner of your mat. If you want to, left hand can place on your left hip or comes out to the side with the palm facing up, just to counterbalance, trying to keep both hips firmly down. So try not to let the left hip come up and away if you can. Good. On the next inhale, lift it back to centre. Take the straps into your left hand. Let that leg travel just over the midline of the body, so not all the way over. Keeping both hips still on the floor. So no lifting off that right hip. Leave that dropping down. Slowly relaxing that leg all the way over. Good. On the next inhale, lift back to centre. Exhale, release that right leg to the floor. And just have a moment. Eyes closed. Breathe. Just take notice of the length of your right body versus the length of your left side. Good, and then when you're ready, place the strap around the ball of your left foot. On the inhale, slowly extend it up to the sky. Let the hands slide down that strap, elbows tucked into the next to the rib cage, and just slowly extending through that left leg. Stop where the knee wants to bend. Keep the hips heavy. Just slowly, slowly hitting into the back of that left leg. Heel reaches up to the sky, toes drop down towards your forehead. You stay there for a couple of breaths and then see if you can, in the next couple of breaths, just inch it just a tiny fraction, a little bit closer towards your chest. Only if it feels okay. Good. Take an inhale and then take the straps into your left hand and then exhale, let that left leg travel out to the left, keeping it as high to the top left corner as you can. Right hand onto your right hip or out to the side, just to counter the weight. Slowly let that left leg relax. So it's almost like a letting go. You're just letting go of the muscles. Good. On the next inhale, come back to centre. Let the straps into your right hand and let the leg only come over the centre line, over to the right. Nice and easy. Stretching the heel away from you, toes back towards you. On the next inhale, come back to centre. Let go of the strap, stretch that left leg along the floor. Close the eyes for a moment. If you want to, take your arms overhead. Get a little stretch. Good, nice and long through the body. And then as you exhale, take the knees into the chest. Little hug, squeeze the knees in. Good. Hands behind the knees, and we'll rock up to seated, and then we're going to roll straight over onto all fours. Shuffle back a little bit on your mat, coming into our cat and cow, wrists underneath the shoulders, spreading the fingers, press the palms down into the mat, the knees are hip width apart, toes are lengthening to the back. Inhale, lift that tailbone, drop the belly, lift your gaze. As you exhale, rounding through that spine, draw the tailbone low, release the head, look through to your feet. Inhale, lift. Working through that spine, curling and extending, connecting, inhaling with lifting up, and exhaling with rounding through your spine. So slowly look right down. Good. Rounding through that spine, lift up belly, release the head, and on the inhale, extending, lift that gaze, tailbone comes up. Good. And then from here we're going to come into a little flow in a moment. We're going to come forward one more time on the inhale. And then come to a neutral spine on the exhale. From here, we're just going to round it between cat, cow, and child's pose. So inhaling, lift your gaze, lift your tailbone, exhaling, rounding through that spine, sitting back to your heels. You can tuck the toes and leave your toes lengthened. Release the elbows and forearms to the mat, chin along the floor as you're inhaling, right to the front, and then push up. Exhaling, rounding through that spine, sitting back to child's pose. Releasing forearms to the floor, chin to the floor. On the inhale, we slide that chin right to the front of the mat and then push up. Exhale, round through that spine, sit back to your heels. Release the forearms, elbows to the mat. Chin slides along the floor to the front of the mat. On the inhale, push up. Exhale, round. Just take it back to the heels. Keep going with that breath and that movement. You're sliding that chin along the floor to the front of the mat. On the inhale, push up. On the exhale, you're rounding through that spine, sitting back to the heels. Forearms down. Chin slides along the mat. Good. Right to the front, lift up. Exhale, rounding through that spine. We'll do one more round. Good. Release the forearms, chin to the floor. Inhaling, sliding it right to the front. Lift. Then this time on the exhale, we're going to round, sit back to child's pose and stay. Settle all the way back to your heels, release that chest to your thighs, release the forehead to the floor. You can take the arms out the front or take them through to the back with the palms up. That's up to you. Just choose the variation that works for you. Good. Lovely. On the next inhale, lift your gaze, come back up onto all fours. Tucking the toes under, lift the seat up and back into downward facing dog. I'm just taking a little walk from side to side, bending one knee, extend the opposite leg, and then take it the other way. Just slowly stretching into the back of the calves, into the legs. Nice and long through your spine. So it's an opportunity to stretch different bits, get into maybe your hips a little bit. Just stretch in a way that feels good for you. Just take a moment. And then when you're ready, come to centre. So from here, we're going to do a little flow. We're going to inhale forward into plank. And then here, just take a moment to adjust your hands and feet. So your wrists are underneath the shoulders. Nice and long through the spine. And I want you to leave the hands and feet where they are as you're flowing through. Take an inhale. Exhale, slowly release down to the floor. Inhaling into cobra or up dog. And exhaling, tucking the toes, lift the seat up and back, downward facing dog. Okay. Inhale forward into plank. Exhale, slowly release. Elbows tucked in. Inhaling, cobra or up dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Inhale forward into plank. Exhale, slowly release. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale forward into plank, nice and steady. Exhale, slowly release to the floor. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. One more round. Inhale forward, slowly, plank. Exhale, slowly release. Inhale, into cobra or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Hold it there. Couple breaths. Perfect. Good. On the next inhale, reach the right toes up to the sky. And then exhale, bend that right knee and drop that right foot over to your left side, onto your left bottom, as much as you can. Keep lifting that right knee up and you're turning the hip out. So it's a little twist, not a big twist. Keeping both hands firmly planted though. And then taking your gaze under your right shoulder up to the sky. Good, hold. On the next inhale, reach the toes up, square the hips to the front of the mat. And then exhale, slowly release that foot back to the floor. Take a breath here. And then a little switch over. Inhale, left toes up to the sky. Exhale, bend that left knee. Take that foot over to your right side. Lift that left hip up. And then take the gaze under your left shoulder. So try and keep the weight evenly distributed through the front of the arms and the hands. Good. On the next inhale, lengthen the toes up to the sky, square the hips to the front of the mat, and then exhale, release that foot back to the floor. Good. Take an inhale, and then exhale, slowly release the knees to the floor. Take the knees to the edges of the mat, connect the toes, sit back into a wide child's pose. Settling all the way back to the heels first, drop that chest to the floor, forehead to the mat. Good. Well done. On the next inhale, lift your gaze, come back up onto all fours, take the knees underneath your hips, sit back onto your heels, and we're coming into half camel pose. So taking the hands behind you, keeping the knees together if you can, just place the hands behind you with the fingertips pointing forward, palms pressing down into the ground. Think about opening across the front of the chest, so there's a big stretch between the shoulders. Like rotating, you really want to rotate the shoulders out and back, bringing the shoulder blades towards each other. Let the hips be nice and heavy, and then keep looking forward. So no lifting of the chin. Good. actually we'll just come into a low squat. Tuck the toes under, take the weight back, come into a low squat, bring the hands together to namaste. Just a little balance. Then on the next inhale, lift up to the sky. And then exhale to Tadasana. Come in towards the front of the mat. We'll do a couple of half sun salute A's and then a couple of full sun salute A's. On the inhale, reach the hands up to the sky, lift your gaze. Exhale, fold forward, long spine, release the head. Bend into the knees if you need to. Inhale, halfway up, hands to shins, look up. And then exhale, step back, right foot, left foot, plank. Nice and steady as you drop down to the floor, inhaling into cobra or up dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Good. Hold it there, just for a couple of breaths. I was going to do half sun salute A's, I've been straight in. Oh well, we'll do that. Good, nice deep breath in, long breath out. On the next inhale, soften the knees, lift the gaze, step it forward, right foot, left foot, come up halfway, hands to shins, look up. On the exhale, fold forward, long spine. Inhale, use your core to lift up to the sky. And exhale to Tadasana. Inhale, reach the fingertips up. Good, lift your gaze, exhale, forward fold, long spine all the way down. Inhale, halfway up, hands to shins, look up. Exhale, step it back, left foot, right foot, plank. Slowly down to the floor with control. Inhaling into cobra or up dog, exhaling down the facing dog. Good, hold it there. Just a couple of breaths. Stretching into your back, into your spine. Lift the hips up high. Good. On the next inhale, soften the knees, lift the gaze, step it forward. Left foot, right foot, come up halfway. Hands to the shins, look up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift it up to the sky. And then exhale back to Tadasana, into sun salute B. Inhale, bend the knees, lift the arms. Exhale, forward fold, all the way down. Inhale, halfway up, hands to shins, look up. Exhale, step it back, right foot, left foot. Nice and steady, drop it down to the floor. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, down, facing dog. Good. Inhale, right toes sweep up to the sky. Exhale, big step forward. We're going to come into a high lunge on the inhale. Exhale, release the hands to the hips and drop the back foot into the floor, but keeping the hips facing forward into a warrior one position. Inhale, reach the hands up, interlace the hands, first finger draws up to the sky. Lift your gaze. Good. So make sure that back foot keeps dropping into the floor. Nice deep bend into the right knee. Here into warrior two, take an inhale, exhale, turn the hips out to the side, open them up, arms down shoulder height, palms facing down, gazing over the middle finger of your front hand. Relax the shoulders, nice and tall through the upper body, a little bit more bend into that front knee if you can, adjust the feet if you need to. Here into Trikonasana, inhale, straighten through that front leg, take an exhale. Inhale, reach forward, hips go back, and then exhale, front hand to the shin. Left fingertips stretch up to the sky, rotate the ribcage, lift your gaze. Good. Lovely, both legs are straight. Nice, palm faces forward. Take an inhale and an exhale, release your gaze down to your big toe. Inhale, lift it all the way up. Exhale, release the hands to the hips, take the toes in, heels out. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold forward, drop the hands to the floor. And from here, we're going to sweep from side to side, through the legs. Take an inhale and an exhale, bend into your left knee. Take the weight over to the left. And then inhale back to centre, straighten through both legs before you exhale. Bend into your right knee, shift the weight over to the right. Good. Inhale back to centre, lengthen through both legs. Exhale, over to the left. Nice deep bend into that knee. Inhale back to centre. Exhale, over to the right. Take your time, arrive into that stretch. Inhale back to centre. Exhale, over to the left. Good. Inhale, center. Exhale, over to the right. Inhale, center, and then exhale, over to the left, and hold. Just a couple of breaths here. Slowly, maybe a little bit more bend into that left knee, only if that feels comfortable. The inside of the opposite leg. Good. Inhale to center, lengthen through both legs. Then exhale over to the right. Take a couple of breaths here. And then see if you can bend a little bit more into that right knee. Slowly. Good. Inhale back to center, lengthen through both legs. Just to release the head for a moment. Pressing the fingertips or palms into the mat. Nice long spine, release the head. Good. On the next inhale, onto your fingertips. Exhale, release the hands to the waist. Inhale, lift it all the way up. Then exhale, step it back to the front of the mat. Good. So as we beat other side, inhale, bend the knees, lift the arms. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway up, looking up. Exhale, step it back, left foot, right foot, plank. Nice and steady as you drop down to the floor. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, left toes up to the sky. Exhale, big step forward. Inhale, lift into high lunge. And then exhale, release the hands to the hips and just drop that back foot into the floor, keeping the hips facing forward. Inhale, reach the hands up, interlace the fingers, first finger draws up to the sky, lift your gaze. Good. Lovely. Just hold it there. On the exhale, see if you can bend a little bit further into that front knee. Relax the shoulders down, away from the ears, but reaching up into your fingertips. From here, we're going to slowly make our way into warrior two. Take an inhale, exhale, open the hips out to the side, bring the arms down shoulder height, palms down, adjust your feet. You can have a little bit of a wider stance, so you can have a little bit more bend into that front knee. Relax the shoulders and then look over the middle finger of your front hand. Good. Into Trikonasana. On the inhale, straighten through that front leg. Take an exhale, maybe adjust the feet if they need to be a little bit shorter. Inhale, reach forward, hips go back. Exhale, front hand to the shin, right fingertips reach up to the sky. Rotate that rib cage and lift your gaze. If it's uncomfortable for the hands, you can drop the arm behind. If you've got any shoulder issues or neck issues, you can look forward or look down. Good. Lovely. Take an inhale and then exhale, release that gaze down to your front toe. Inhale, lift it all the way up. Exhale, release the hands to the waist, take the toes in, heels out. Take an inhale, lift. Exhale, fold forward, hands drop down to the floor, release the head. Pressing the left hand down into the floor, either fingertips or palm. On the inhale, right fingertips reach all the way up, rotating that ribcage and lift your gaze. Exhale back to centre, press the right palm or fingertips into the floor. Left hand reaches up, rotate that ribcage around to the left, lift your gaze. Exhale back to centre. Inhale, right side, reach up into your fingertips, rotate. Exhale, centre. Inhale, left side, reach up. Good. Exhale, centre. Inhale, right side, all the way up. Exhale, centre. Inhale, left side, reach. Exhale, centre. Inhale, right side, and hold. See if you can lift that right finger, those right fingertips all the way up, rotate that ribcage, lift your gaze up to the sky, pressing the left hand firmly down into the ground, use that as leverage to bring you further into that twist. Good, take an inhale and exhale, release that right hand to the floor, inhale, left side, rotate all the way down. Pressing that right palm or fingertips down into the floor. Use that to bring yourself around a little bit more. Lift that gaze up to the sky. Good. Take an inhale and then exhale. Release that hand to the floor. Just take a breath here. A couple of breaths. Release the head, the spine. Nice and long through the upper body. Inhale onto your fingertips. Exhale. Release the hands to the waist. Inhale, lift it all the way up. And then exhale, step it back to Tadasana. Look, vinyasa down to the floor. Inhale, lift the hands up. Exhale, forward fold, long spine. Inhale, halfway up, hands to shins. Exhale, step it back to plank. Right foot, left foot. All the way down. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Nice and long through the spine. Just take a breath. Good. On the next inhale, right toes sweep up to the sky. And then exhale, big step forward. Release that left knee to the floor, coming into a low lunge. Inhale, reach the hands up to the sky. Exhale, then reach behind, grab opposite elbows. And then slowly release into that lunge. So nice deep bend into that front knee. Good. Opening up across the front of the chest. Lift your gaze if that feels comfortable. With each exhale, just slowly release into that front hip flexor. Good. On the next inhale, release the hands. Sweep the hands up to the sky. Exhale, hands to the mat. Inhale, runner's lunge, lengthen to that right leg, keep the hips high. Either the palms press down or fingertips press down into the mat. Front foot is lifted, take your gaze to your big toe. Inhale, shift it to the front of the mat, and then exhale, step it back down the facing dog. Inhale, left toes up to the sky. Exhale, big step forward. Then release that right knee, lengthen the toes. Inhale, reach up. And then exhale, reach the hands behind. Switch the grip around to your opposite elbows, and then slowly release into that stretch. Nice deep bend into that front knee. Each time you exhale, just slowly dropping into that front hip flexor. Lift the gaze if that feels comfortable, or just continue to look forward. Either option is good. Good. On the next inhale, release the hands, sweep them up to the sky. Exhale, hands to the mat. Inhale, lengthen through that left leg, runner's lunge, keep the hips high. Pressing the fingertips or palms into the mat. Looking at your big toe. I'll step it back to downward facing dog. And then from here, we're going to move forward. Take an inhale, right shin forward, drop it to the floor, take the other one behind, and then come through to seated. Taking a wide leg, nice and long, sitting up tall, take an inhale, and then exhale, slide the hands down the legs, either to the shin, or if you can grab hold of the big toes, grab those. Think about extending that spine and then dropping that chest down towards the floor. Elbows come out to the side rather than dropping them down. It just gives you that room to come forward. If it feels more accessible, then you can use a strap, as you have one ready already. Good. Just nice and easy. Drawing yourself down towards the earth. Inhale, release the toes or the shins, lift all the way up. Take the hands underneath the knees and then just bring the feet together. So if you've got that strap, keep hold of it. Sit up nice and tall, take an inhale and then exhale, fold forward, hands to the shins or to the outside of your feet. If you're really super flexible, you can take the hands behind the feet and then grab hold of your wrist, opposite wrist, if that feels comfortable. If not, just hold the outside of the feet. Or you can just grab hold of the toes. So there's different variations of holding the feet. They all have different names. But I think a forward fold, just make it accessible and comfortable for you. Relax the back of the knees down to the floor.
I just want a touch on your feet.
If that's your aim, then that's what you work towards.
Yeah.
Much better though. Good. Lovely. On the next inhale, lift up. Then exhale, if you've got a strap, release. Bend the knees, place the soles of the feet together, wrap the hands around the toes. Little shuffle towards your heels with your bottom. Relax the knees out to the side, nice and tall, long through the spine. Take an inhale. And then exhale, drop that chin down towards your chest. So either gazing at your big toes or maybe this is always a nice pose to close your eyes in. I find myself probably closing my eyes in most of the seating positions. Just drawing everything in. Good. On the next inhale, lift your gaze. Exhale, slide the feet out in front, take the elbows in front of the shins, and then as you exhale, round through that spine, release the head into that space in front. Feel your breath shift as you do so. Yourself up, hands underneath the knees, lift them back together and then roll down onto your back. From here into a supine twist, inhale your right knee into your chest, stretch that left leg away, right arm out, shoulder height, palm up, and then exhale, draw that knee over to your left, keep the shoulders dropping down into the mat. Take the gaze to the palm of your right hand. Inhale back to centre, exhale, both feet back to the floor with the knees bent. Inhale your left knee into the chest, extend that right leg along the floor, left arm out shoulder height, palm up. Then exhale, draw that knee over to your right side. Turn to gaze at the palm of your left hand. Just slowly let that top leg relax, let it drop down. On the next inhale, come back to centre. Both feet back to the floor with the knees bent. Drop the knees in towards each other. Take the feet to the edges of the mat. Let the lower back drop into the floor. Close the eyes. We'll just take a moment to come back to the intention and the breath. Hopefully that breath is still flowing with purpose. You're still breathing mindfully. Deep breath in, long breath out. We'll do three or four of those. Deep breath in, into your belly, and then long breath out. Arriving just a moment before you then breathing in. Let the whole body fill with the breath and then breathing out. Good, and then let that breath go. Let it relax, let it be soft. Nothing to be mindful about with the breath, nothing to control. Just let it be. And taking a moment to come back to the intention. I feel grounded. I feel connected. I feel connected and grounded. Repeat that a couple of times, two or three times. Good. And then let that go. And then from here, we're slowly going to make our way into Shavasana. If it feels comfortable, stretch the legs away from you. Let the toes drop out to the side. If it feels more comfy to keep the knees bent, then you're welcome to do so. Reaching the heels away from you to find a little bit more length through the back of the legs. Tiny little tilt of the chin down towards the chest to find a little bit more length through the back of the neck. Good. Relaxing the whole of the body from the crown of the head down to the tips of your toes. From the tips of your toes all the way out to the crown of your head. With each breath, let the whole of your body relax. With each breath, let the whole of the body soften. With each breath, allow your body to let go. Taking this time to let the body absorb the practice, the movements, the breath. Just a little bit of time to let your mind wander. Let it drift. toes. And stretching into your hands and into your feet. Bringing energy back into the body by taking a deep breath in through the nose. And a big breath out through the mouth. Deep breath in. Big breath out. Deep breath in. Big breath out. Good. On the next inhale, sweep the arms up behind you. Bring the feet together. Long stretch. And then breathing out, bring the arms up and over. Knees into your chest. Give yourself a hug. A little rock from side to side. Then keeping the knees bent and the eyes closed, slowly roll it over to your right side. Relax the legs and the feet. And when you're ready, placing your left hand to the floor, gently use that to press yourself up to a seated position, either with the legs crossed or legs out in front. And then when you're ready, placing the palms together and gently pressing the thumbs back into your chest. And then from here, we will close the practice with one round of om. Taking a deep breath in. Your peace and your thoughts, your words, your actions and your heart. Om Shanti. Namaste. Thank you for your practice.